Disney has been producing live-action remakes slash reimaginings of many of their animated classics for a long time now. It really became a notable trend in the 2010s when they started with Alice in Wonderland. They had produced a couple before that, like you had the 101 Dalmatians film with Glenn Close that came out in the 90s.
Oh, yeah.
That was a great movie, but I think that they decided to go ahead and make this a more formulaic sort of trend in terms of their blockbuster tempos that they were going to release on a consistent basis. And we've gotten a lot of them. We've gotten The Lion King and Aladdin and a variation of Sleeping Beauty with Maleficent and others, you know, that have come out. And they've enjoyed varying degrees of success. Some have been super successful financially, creatively. Some of them have been, I think, fine. And you also have had some notable misfires in there as well. And so it's just kind of been all over the place. The Little Mermaid, of course, is one of their more beloved animated classics. It really kickstarted the Disney Renaissance of the 90s, which just completely turned around their fortunes and made them once again the juggernaut in animation that they had come to know themselves to be in the 30s, 40s, and 50s. And of course, The Little Mermaid, in terms of becoming a live action film, you would have to suspect that that was going to be one of their more anticipated projects. You add that on top of the fact that Halle Bailey had been casted for this role as Ariel a long time ago. I think maybe about 3 or 4 years ago, she's been cast in this role. And I think for a number of us, that was an incredibly exciting prospect. We know that she has vocal chops for certain. And she's also been a pretty seasoned actor up until this point and has had acting experience. And so many of us were excited, but there was also, you know, maybe some concerns from another group of people who didn't want to see a black Ariel. That's a whole nother conversation for another day, possibly. But I think in terms of a live action movie, there was a lot to look forward to. But with all of that out the way, let's go ahead and talk about this movie and get into our thoughts about it. I will pass it over to you. What were your big picture thoughts and your overall reaction to The Little Mermaid?
The Black Mermaid is here, man. What a time to be alive. I'll never forget, actually. I was watching Grown-ish when she got casted. And it's funny because she was in the show, her and Halle both were in the show pretty frequently. And after she got casted, they kind of like wrote her off, or they like made her go somewhere remote. Like she was like in the Olympics or something, and like it's also funny because they would like FaceTime her into things in the show, but her hair would be covered. So like you wouldn't know that they were dyeing her hair red. It was a whole thing. And I just think that's so interesting seeing that in real time after she got casted. But so this is, again, it's been a long time coming. Like I've been watching this unfold for like 4 years. It's kind of crazy to think about it like that. But it's finally arrived. It's finally here. And man, I like it, but I wish I liked it more. That is like the best tagline I can say for this movie. I like it, but I wish I liked it more. The Little Mermaid, I will say, the source material, the original movie, was always good to me, but not great to me, right? It never was like Mulan for me. It was never Lion King for me. It was never like that for me. It was always something I liked. Even there, they even came out with a cartoon. He's been on Toon Disney, like the Little Mermaid cartoon. I used to watch that too, and that was fine. I like that stuff. But again, I just never loved it. It was something about it. I don't know. I couldn't put my finger on it why I didn't love it as much. But again, I always really liked it, and I always really liked the music. Under the Sea is a classic, like top 10 Disney songs. Like Under the Sea is fire. And so I was still looking forward to this. Of course, beyond Halle, you know, playing Ariel in this movie, I was still looking forward to it because it is a Disney classic. And so coming into this, I was pretty excited. And yeah, it was okay, man. It was pretty much a one-to-one depiction of the movie for the most part. And I think maybe that took away from the movie a little bit. I think a lot of times if you're going from animated to live action, I would like for you to add something to it. If you're remaking anything, you know, a lot of times I'm like, okay, add something. Don't just make it live action. Add a little razzle dazzle somewhere to show us, okay, this was worth it. And I think, you know, some of those other films like Cinderella 2015 live action, I like that because it feels like it added something. I actually really like Cruella because it feels like it added something to me. And for here, I feel like it adds a little something, but not enough for me to go, oh, okay, I love that they made this live action movie. And I do still love that they made it, don't get me wrong, but it still feels like something's missing as I'm watching this movie. This half CGI animal thing was throwing me off. It was a worry coming in. It was a worry in the trailer, and it went through after seeing the film. I felt the exact same way, where what kind of works. Sebastian has like these cartoony eyes. That kind of works a little bit. Flounder does not work at all. He's just a fish. You know what I'm saying? Or like Scuttle is like just a bird and it's Awkwafina. So I don't know. It's like things I feel like that they, it just doesn't work because it's Uncanny Valley. This feels kind of weird when you're looking at it. Again, I think maybe if they had played with making Flounder seem more, making his eyes more vibrant or making him look cooler, it might have worked because it kind of worked for Sebastian a little bit. You know what I mean? Like there was like a half and half with Sebastian. It's like, this almost makes sense to me because his expressions could come through a little bit better because they made him almost look like half Mr. Krabs, half real crab. It was really crazy. So yeah, that took away from me a little bit as well. And so long story short, everything in the water kind of didn't work for me. A lot of the water stuff didn't work for me. And unfortunately, that includes Under the Sea, which I was really excited for. I thought that was going to be this over the top, crazy music number. And it ends up just being like fine. You know what I mean? Because there are things that you can do in animation that you can't do in live action. And it just works better in animation. There are so many animals, underwater animals and sea creatures doing things in the animated one. And in this one, it's like, y'all kind of don't do it. You know, there's like the moment where there's like people dressed up as turtles and like moving. And it just wasn't as colorful and as crazy as I was hoping it would be. You know what I mean? Versus a movie like Aladdin, which did feel, with some of those sequences did feel like, oh, this is crazy. I love that they're doing this. It just doesn't work for the underwater sequences in this movie for me. And that's unfortunate because Under the Sea, again, that was the banger I was looking for. And it just fell short for me. What I will give it is the stuff on land mostly worked for me. I actually think Halle Bailey's and what's Eric's actor's name? I always forget.
Jonah Howard King.
Halle Bailey and Jorah Howard King, I actually like their chemistry. I thought they did pretty well. Again, everything on land pretty much worked for me. But again, it was a one-for-one telling for the most part, you know? But that is the heart of the story. And I think that's why I still like the movie is because of everything that was happening on land with those two. I thought it was still fine. They changed very small things with the engagement and things. But overall, man, again, I like it. I just wish I liked it more. And that's really all I can say about it. A lot of it is the underwater stuff. If they had cleaned up a lot of that, I think I would have liked it way more than I did. But it didn't work for me. One more thing I'll add. I actually do love the message. It's like a really cool message at the end with mermaids. And I was like, I rock with that. Thank you for doing that, Disney. There was like a nod in there that I actually really appreciated that they did. That was like, yes, I like this. I think it ended on a good note. I will give them that. Ended on a good note. It made me feel happy a little bit like proud that they had done something like that. But other than that, man, it was fine. And I was looking for a little bit more, but I'm still glad that Halle Bailey got this opportunity and that she'll be Ariel to a lot of kids, you know, from here on out. I think it's huge. The representation is amazing. I'm looking forward to them making, I think, more swings like this. Though it was a swing for them to cast Halle in the first place, even though it shouldn't be, you know what I mean, but they went with it and they stuck, and I think they stuck that part of the Little Mermaid is the casting in general.
So I will certainly be the first to admit that I am not really a fan of these Disney live action remakes that they've been producing. There have been a couple of examples that are good. I don't think any of them are great. I think that they have produced, honestly, some of the most creatively bankrupt pieces of a film that Disney has worked on over the past like 15 or so years. Like they just kind of scream just business and box office to me. Like that's really the only reason that I think a lot of them are produced, just because of the easy cash that they know that they're going to make off of them. Again, there are a couple of exceptions. Like I think that they did something really interesting with Maleficent, the first one. I do like Cinderella. Cruella took it in a completely different direction and had a lot of style and pizzazz that was sort of infused into that story. But really outside of that, we're just looking at something that is just like, well, why are we doing this? Why are we here? Of course, like a new generation is going to consume these films and start to compare them to the animated classics. But also this generation of young kids that are watching these things, they have access to those animated classics on Disney Plus. And a lot of them are still seeing those movies. Like a lot of people are still watching the animated Little Mermaid or the animated Lion King. Like it's not like they're going to be without those things. And I don't honestly know how many people are gonna go and pick the live action Lion King over the animated version? Like, if you only have 2 hours to spare and you're gonna watch one, I think 10 out of 10 people are gonna pick the animated Lion King. Like, it just makes sense to me. So coming into this one, I felt similarly that The Little Mermaid has always been good to me, but not necessarily one of my more adored animated classics. It's not been one of my favorites. And so I wasn't all that excited for this movie, but just based off of those two elements and ideas, that the fact that The Little Mermaid has been fine, and also these live action movies just have not done it for me. I also recently just saw Peter Pan and Wendy on Disney Plus, which was,
oh my God,
bad. And then I also watched Pinocchio with Tom Hanks that came out last year. That is a really, really awful movie. So the streak has just not been there. It's just like, I don't even know why we're still in this territory anymore. We know ultimately the financial gains, but this just hasn't been working for me. And so coming into this one, my expectations were honestly just low. I was looking for Halle Bailey to shine and excel in that particular role, but not really much else. And to be honest, that's pretty much what I got. This movie overall is just mid-level to me. It's the definition of a mid-film. It's not the worst thing that they've done in terms of the live-action remakes, but it's far from the best. I think that when you look at creating a new story or trying to introduce some new elements to this, this is probably the example of going way too far. This movie is 2 hours and 15 minutes, and it has no reason to be. The first animated movie is like an hour 36. So now we're talking an added 40 minutes worth of story to this film. There's really no reason for that. And much of it is kind of dedicated to the stuff that happens on land. And in particular with Eric, who they have made the choice to sort of flesh out his background and give him a little bit more in terms of a character, which I guess makes sense. Like, you want him to have as much of an emotional investment to the script and to the story that they're telling. But if I'm just being real, I don't give a fuck about Eric. I never did. I don't know many people that do. Like, this is about Ariel at the end of the day. So to expand his story and to really spend some more time with him, I was just sitting there like, do we really, really need this? Or are we just doing this to appease the fact that, oh yeah, he's a male character, and so we're going to give him a little bit more screen time and a little bit more material to work with? So that stuff just didn't work for me. There's no reason this movie needs to be as long as it is. I think it's definitely 30 minutes too long, you know, and I think that they could have shortened a lot of it. Yeah. The sea creatures and the underwater nature of it is just always going to be a challenge. I mean, when you have movies like Avatar, The Way of Water coming out, and you see what's capable with the water and what James Cameron and his team achieve with that, and then you just look at this, it's not the same game we're playing at all. It's not the same league. You just look at the stuff here, and it's not terrible in terms of the visual nature of it, but it's also just not the best that it could be. You do want a little bit more vibrancy, a little bit more life that's injected into that stuff, and you're starting to blend the real with the animated and the uncanny, and it just doesn't work. I totally agree with the stuff that you said about characters like Flounder and Sebastian, which it's just like, I just don't emotionally connect to these characters because they just look like animals, and we're trying to infuse life into them, and it's just like this stuff isn't coming together in the way that you would want it to. And then the last thing that I guess that I'll mention is, on a positive note, Halle Bailey. I think that she's pretty incredible. I think that she does a lot here. Her vocal expertise can certainly not be denied or doubted. Like, we've known her to be just a tremendous singer, and that's certainly present here. I think that her delivery of a lot of those songs in which she has to lead with just such a strong vocal performance, I honestly got chills at a couple moments just hearing her really sing to the capabilities that we know that she can achieve. And that was great stuff. The unfortunate thing, which is similar to the animated movie, is that the character of Ariel has to be silent for most of it. We just don't get to hear her. That's just due to the nature of the story. And that's due in part to the fact that Melissa McCarthy coming here as Ursula, you know, sort of presents her with a curse that takes away her voice. And Melissa McCarthy as Ursula also had some pretty big shoes to fill. I think for the first half of the movie, she's kind of a nothing character, but she really comes to life about midway through when you start to see her manifest and really become the true villain that we know Ursula to be. So by the middle of it and towards the end, I actually kind of like what they did with Ursula as well. And I thought that the visual representation of her was really cool. The CGI on her character, especially when she starts to become really big and bombastic.
Kaiju.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and that stuff actually started to look really good to me. But I think that this film is just like, it's just another example of why do we need these movies? Why is it here? What is it really adding to the, I guess, to the lore and the mythos of the Little Mermaid to justify its existence? And we're always going to ask that question anytime they go back to the well with these animated classics, because those movies still hold up really, really well for the most part. There's a few problematic ones, don't get me wrong, but most of them still, they still hold up very well, and they still can translate to this new generation of audiences. But I think that this one is, it's fine, it's okay, but a lot of it just kind of chips away at the fact that these movies just always feel like they have no actual purpose for being in existence, mm-hmm. because they're not adding enough new material to make them creatively invigorating to the level and to the degree in which I hope they would be. But that might just be asking too much out of a massive corporation like Disney at this point. So with all of that out the way, folks, those are our thoughts on Disney's live action reimagining of The Little Mermaid. If you've checked out this movie in theaters, definitely hit us up and let us know what you think.